Hi, welcome back to Element 14 Presents. I'm Katie, and in today's episode, I'm going to be making a fidget cube. So, most of us have seen fidget toys. They've become quite popular recent years. You can get the spinny ones, or you can get cubes, or you can get other types, but I'm going to be looking at the cube. So this has got six faces on the cube, and each face has something different. Some is just a tactile feel, some are rubbery buttons, some of which click and some of which are spongy, twirly discs, clicky switches, sort of a joystick, and a trackball with some clicky wheels. What about if we had an electronics fidget cube? So my aim is to have on each side a separate mini circuit that will light up, will display something, will make a noise. So that's my plan. Let's get started. So my ideas for the cube are that it has to be a fidget cube, so there needs to be six sides. So all the sides are going to be powered from the same power source inside the cube. No side must be dependent on another side. However, one of the sides will contain all the connectors for distributing the power. So there'll be a power side that will need to be in each cube, but the rest of the sides will be independent. And then I need to think of what's going to be on my sides. So I want something interactive. There needs to be some input from the user and an output. But this input could be any sort of input. It doesn't necessarily have to be buttons, although that's the most obvious one. And the output could be something visual, LEDs lighting up, something audible, a sound being generated, or tactile. I've not really thought so much about that one yet, but I guess something moving, so you could have like a little motor to make a vibration sense or something. So this is my plan. Now six sides is going to be quite a lot, so I'm going to start off with three sides and see where it takes me from there. So I've thought of three sides to start off with. Thought of quite a instant gratification button that will just turn on LEDs. Now this is quite a simple side, but that's because I'm going to use this side to contain all the power supply circuitry. So take in a battery input and output it onto five other outputs to connect the other five sides to. I've then thought, I used to really like the Etch-a-Sketch. I've always wanted to make a digital Etch-a-Sketch. So I'm going to have a little joystick. I can do up, down, left, right with an LCD, and then I can just draw a picture of a continuous line drawing. And then for the third side, it's going back to the buttons, but adding a little more complexity. I've got this ruler on my desk. I sit here quite often and fiddle. I really like the logic gates. You tell it what logic gate you want and it will give you the output. I quite like that. So I'm going to come up with something with like a logic gate calculator on. And the other part of this that I often sit and fiddle with is there's a 4-bit binary counter. You can go up and down. So I'm going to do something on my third side with that. Now, before I start designing, I need to think about what I'm going to do. So the traditional fidget cube is just over 1 inch cubed. Sort of the flat area seems to be 1 inch, and then the edges push it just over. So I'm going to bear that in mind and see if I can make my circuits come out to the same size cube. It's going to be really tight, so I might have to revise that when I get to doing the PCB layout. But for a first start, I'm going to try 1 inch square PCBs, and then the frame that will hold them will push it just over 1 inch. So let's get started drawing out the circuits for these three sides. So this is the circuit for what I'm calling the power board. So this is going to have a connector for the battery input. I've then got this IC here, which is a switch controller. So this is going to require you to press two buttons to turn it on and off. So it's a bit harder than something you can fidget with. So you're not going to accidentally turn it on and off all the time. So once you've pressed the two buttons, it will then power on this battery on. This is being fed into the boost circuit. It's got automatic low battery warnings. So this comes down to here and will bring on a red LED, but it will also output 5 volts. So once this 5 volt line is high, this green LED will come on to show you that the power's on. And then this switch controller, which is the same as we were using before, will be on. And when you push that button, it's a momentary push, but it will latch on and light up these 8 LEDs, which will surround this push button until you push it again, and then it will turn off. And then as a separate side, as soon as you've powered it on and you've got the 5 volts, it will put 5 volts onto these 5 connectors for the other 5 sides of the cube to plug into and to get their power from. Let's have a look at the PCB. So this is the PCB design. So this is the rear side of the board. It's got the 3-pin battery connector and the 5 side outputs. And then if I flip it over, this is going to be the side that the user can see. So I'm going to have a push button and a slide button. These both have to be activated together, and then the 5 volt line will be active. This green LED will come on here. If the battery voltage is too low, this red one will come on. And when you push this push button, these LEDs will all come on around it. And when you push it back again, they'll come off. So this is the first side. My second side is I'm calling sketch. So this takes in the power. It's converting 5 volts down to 3 volts. I've got a 5-direction switch. So I've got 4 directions up, down, left, right, and a middle push on that switch. I've got a separate switch to clear the screen. I've then got this AVR, which is going to be my microcontroller for driving the screen and taking the inputs from the joystick. And this is the screen connector, which is going to go out to my OLED display. Let's have a look at the PCB for this. I haven't got the joystick modelled here, but that's going to go on this footprint here. I've got a push button for clear. I've got the outline for the LCD and a cutout for the ribbon cable to come across. The rear of this has the AVR microcontroller, my 5 volt to 3 volt converter, the input from the power board, and this connector here. So I can't find an actual physical connector to take the ribbon cable from the screen. So I'm going to lay it flat and solder bridge across from the cable to the PCB. And then my third side is the logic side. So I've got the 5 volts coming in. I'm not converting it this time. I'm using it as 5 volts. I've got the microcontroller. This is the same AVR as I was using on the other board, but powered on 5 volts. And then I've got switch inputs for count up and count down and 6 LEDs. So it's going to be a 6-bit binary counter. And then I've got an A and a B input, an indicator to show A and B switched on, which ones are on. And then I've got the outputs for OR, XOR, NOR, XNOR, AND, and NAND. And this will show you the logic calculation of the A and B that you've currently set. And if I go into 3D mode, you can see what it looks like. I've got the 4 inputs. I've got the A and B indicator, I've got the logic outputs, and I've got the 6-bit binary counter. And if I flip it over, you can see the power input and the microcontroller. So that's the boards. I'm going to send off the design files to be made into PCBs, and then I can solder them up.
Are you an engineer, electronics hobbyist, or maker? Join the Element for Teen community, where you can learn about new products and technologies, see cool projects, and connect directly with the people that make the products and engineers that use them. Join now!
my PCBs are going to need something to hold them together in a cube shape. So I'm going to 3D print a frame, and I've designed this in FreeCAD. I've got this bottom part here. There's a slot to put the PCB in at the bottom, and four slots on the edges to slot the PCBs in down the side. Now, this is only half the height because I've then got a duplicate of it, so I'll print two the same. It will all slot together and hold all six PCBs. So I've got my three PCBs all soldered up now. My first thing I'm going to do is test them out. The ones with the AVRs on are going to need programming, so I'm going to program these up. I've got MPLAB-X and I've got the Snap in Circuit Debugger Programmer. With some of the AVR chips, including this one, there's a note that if it doesn't work, you might need to put a pull-up in to override this. So I've done this in this programming harness here. I've got my power supply set to 5 volts. This is just so I can test it's all working as well before I plug the battery in. So for the logic board, I'm going to do first, I'm just going to power it up.
I'm setting up functions for writing commands to the screen and writing data and an initialization. These are all the commands the screen needs to set it up ready to display. And then I've also got separate code to run on the logic calculator PCB.
So now to test it, I'm going to plug in my 5 volt power supply. I can put A on, or X or NAND. I can turn that off and put B on, and I've got OR, X or NAND. Take that off again, it goes back to X or NOR and NAND. I can put both of them on, and I've got OR, X or AND. So that's all correct on the logic calculator side. And then my binary counter, I can go up all the way through, and when it gets to the top, it stops there, ready to go back down. I can stop midway and go back the other way. I can continue all the way down, and then it's ready to go back up again. So that's the logic board tested. Next, I'm going to test the sketchboard. This is on the same 5 volts because it's got the same 3 volt converter. I made a slight mistake with this. I put the button in the way it showed it in the pictures in the data sheet, but actually it's 45 degrees out. Up is that way, down is that way, left and right. So I'm going to do a version 2 of the board for in the files. So, and I'll change my board, but this is how it is for now. So I can go and draw my line up. I can go across to the right. I can go back down. And I can go left. If I press clear, it will clear the screen and leave me ready to draw from the last place it was. But if I press the middle on the joystick, I can either draw straight from that position again, or I can press it and clear and start again from the middle. I'm going to use a little bit of double-sided sticky tape to stick my screen in position. So that's ready. And then my power board, if I press the on button and the slider, it will turn on. I can then press the middle button and flick it on and off for all the lights. And then if I press the on off button, it won't turn off, but if I press it and the slider, it will go back off. So I'm really pleased with that. That's all ready to go as well. I've got these pre-made little Molex cables. So these are just going to go in here and connect up to the other boards to power them. So I'm going to assemble this and then we can have a look at it working. ready and assembled. I've just put some spare PCBs that I've not populated in to blank off the sides that I've not got boards for. Let's have a closer look. Really pleased with how this has come out. It's really good fun. It's all mainly based on buttons and LED or the OLED output, but it is really good fun to fiddle with. Now I've still got these three blank sides. I think it'd be really cool to have something a bit different off the buttons and lights theme. So I was thinking sounds or motion. There's a blog post on the Element 14 website, but I'd love to know what you think I should do next, and then we'll have a part two where I complete my cube with your ideas. So in that part two, I'm also probably going to rethink the 3D printed frame that it's all sat in. This works quite well and it holds it together, but it's extremely delicate. I've gone through loads of them because the little posts that are on the inside break off. So I need to think of something that will be a bit stronger. If you've got any ideas, let me know in the comments on the community page. Thanks, and I'll see you next time. Bye.